Hey YouTube family, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a little bit of a different video. It is going to be on PCOS and how I was diagnosed with it. It's not really an easy, topic to talk about, but a lot of people are, battling with it in this world. So I know I bring everything to y'all, so I thought I would bring this also. First off, if you're new here, please like, comment, and subscribe, because I would love to have you part of our family. It's a family-friendly channel. So let's go ahead and get into this video. So, as most of y'all know, I haven't taken pregnancy tests the last few months because I haven't had a cycle. I am 6 months postpartum, almost 7 months postpartum. So I thought maybe it was just not everything's regulated yet. But I went in yesterday just to get checked because I felt bloated, felt just nasty altogether. And the doctor told me that it's most likely PCOS, but he's still going to run some blood work to check for thyroid problems and some other stuff, he said, just to make sure that everything's normal. And he also is gonna check for PCOS so he can rule it off as that's what it is. But he just said by the symptoms, that is what it sounds like it is. And what PCOS PCOS is when you do not ovulate and your eggs do not release, so you're not having a period, and it can get serious, he said, later on down the road if you don't take care of it. It can cause ovarian, uterine, and one more cancer. So of course I do not want that, so I'm gonna take care of it, But he said that if it is PCOS, that he is going to start me on a low dose of birth control pills. Because I explained to him that a few years down the road from now, maybe 3 or 4 years, we want to try for another baby. And he said that he's going to put me on birth control just because it'll regulate my cycles and keep me ovulating. So that's a good thing that he can do that for me. And he also said that anytime I was ready, if I couldn't get pregnant, he would put me on some kind of medicine. I can't remember the name, but it was some kind of medicine to help me get pregnant, to help me ovulate. So PCOS is not a fun thing to have, especially if you don't have a baby at all and you're really trying hard. But I've seen people get pregnant with it. It is not impossible to get pregnant with PCOS. It's just harder. But if you don't take care of it, what will happen is your lining in your uterus will keep getting thicker and thicker and thicker, and that's what causes cancer. So if you have it, you want to take care of it. Like, you want to take birth control just to get your cycles regulated. You want to do all the precautionary stuff that you can do to keep it from getting to that point. And what my doctor said, he put me on some medicine to start my period just because I haven't had it in around 4 months. So he put me on some, and he said it's like a DNC, which hurts my heart because, Sorry, it's my son. I had a miscarriage. I'm not pregnant, but a DNC is what you have to have to clean everything out from your uterus after a miscarriage. So when he said DNC, it was just like, it brought back all those memories of when I had the miscarriage. I was saying, I get the results back in a week. So whenever I get them back, I will update y'all on what they said and just confirm that it is PCOS, or if it is PCOS. So I'm gonna go ahead and get off of here. And yeah, if y'all have any more questions, y'all let me know down below. And you know, just talk to me. So I hope y'all enjoyed this video, and I hope y'all found it helpful for the ones that are going through this too. You're not the only one. There is ways that can help you to get pregnant. There is ways to keep you ovulating and keep you having a cycle. So don't think there's not. But with that said, I'm going to go ahead and get off. And I hope y'all enjoyed this video, and I will see y'all for the next one. Bye, guys.